Welcome back to the channel and Happy New Year if you're watching this in 2024. We're going to go over some of the biggest Excel features that were added in 2023. Some of them were done using beta tests, so that doesn't necessarily mean that they'll be out in 2024, but testing's being done. We can anticipate, you know, them to be added to the original version of Excel soon. And if you're not an insider and on the beta channel, I'll show you how to do that a little later in the video, so stick around for that. And so to kick it off, we'll get into Microsoft adding Python into Excel. So if you have the Beta Insider Edition, you go to Formulas, you will have an Insert Python and initialization of this. So you can see if you're familiar with Python at all, it will import these libraries for you automatically when you open Excel. And these are some of the more useful libraries, as you can do tons of things with them. And this is a huge feature that Microsoft is adding as it's trying to get Python, you know, easier access and people more familiar with it, since it's such a useful data analysis and data science tool. So let's quickly go over some of the features. So to get Python or a Python formula, you can type equals py. So this creates a Python formula. And so you can use control and enter to commit Python code. But if we just grab this table here, be Excel table one all headers equals true. But if we just hit control enter, it will create a data frame, which is pretty much where it's housing this. So you can see that it has the table stored in here. And there's also a field you can ask array preview. So that automatically brings up the table with the data inside. You can also create a string for some analysis if you wanted to in the type. So that's nice that you can store all of this. And we can get rid of this array preview by just deleting that cell. So this is storing the data in this frame. And so with Python, it's great at visualization and compiling huge amounts of data. It's a very small amount of data, so you know, you're likely never going to use Python for, you know, a small table like this, but there are ways to plot. So as we can see over here, import seaborne as SNS. So we can type equal pi to create a Python formula. And we can type line plot equals SNS dot line plot. And then instead of grabbing the whole table with rank, we can just grab this right here. Header equals true, which you need to close the parentheses, control enter. So if we just click on this, we can see the image is a line graph. And if we also add a field, you can create the image, which is extremely small. So you need to make this rather large for it to enlarge, and you can see it creates a line graph in the order of our data. And this will be useful for large amounts of data and just really getting some nice visuals. So before we go any further, if you're interested in joining the Microsoft 365 Insider Program, I'll leave this link in the description. So it has some easy instructions. When you're in Excel or any other application, you can click account, and then under product information, you can determine your eligibility, and you're going to want to join Microsoft Insider and the beta edition. And this has some nice instructions to get it done. So you're going to want to do that if you're interested in having early access to features to help test them. And also from this page, if you click blog and then you go down to Excel, it will have some new features that are getting rolled out. And we'll get into some of these later for some new features. But this is a great tool to figure out what's coming out in Excel and some new stuff. And so another really cool feature added is Checkbox. So say we have a project here and we have some different elements like design, logistics, implementation, all things that, you know, we'll want to get done for this project, and it could be limitless, as, you know, as many as you need for different projects. So if we just grab all these cells right here and go to insert, there is now a checkbox control, which is also an insider beta channel that Excel will update yours with if you're in the Insider program. So if we just click checkbox, it will add all these checkboxes, which is great. So they have a value of false, and whenever you hit it equals true. So it means we could do a quick formula like this. So we could do equals if this is equal to true, the value of true, we could do, since there's three of them, 33.3. And if it's false, we'll just do zero. And so we can just drag this over and down And so now if we click one of these, they'll equal 33.3. So this is probably just the fastest way. And then what we're going to want to do is equal the sum, or we can just do plus each of these and then drag this down. And so now when we click any of these, they will add 33.3. And so what we can actually do is just round this and just do it by zero digits. So now whenever we add these, quickly hide these. You can see that they will increment, and we can also just add a little conditional formatting here. So we could do the minimum as a number, which zero is perfect. And then this also is a number, which we can do 100. We can make this bar green just to show that progress is being done. And so now whenever you add these, it does add a bar. And the last features that are part of a beta test that is going on in 2023 and will likely be released at some point in either 2024 or 25 are new aggregation functions. They're actually not released on the current beta channel that I have, but they will be group by and pivot by. And aggregation functions are always great because it can allow you to do data aggregations in a easy to use formula, you know, similar to like what a pivot table can get you or something like an XLOOKUP, but it will aggregate based on a certain group. So group by, you have to insert what you want to group by. So in this case, the table of category or the column of category in the table, and then you want to aggregate the sales, and the function you want to is sum. So it's taking the sum of sales for every category. And pivot by, which is just like group by, but lets you add a column. So in this case, you can aggregate them by the category and the year and a total for even a larger breakdown. So these are similar to like pivot tables, how you can add in a year and a category and the sum of sales and do calculated fields, but it's a much simpler way and likely much quicker depending on the amount of data you have. So these are two exciting functions that are being added into Excel, and I will make a video covering them when they are available on the beta channel to keep you guys updated. That's all I have for you in this video. And if you enjoyed the video, please remember to like and subscribe. And thanks for watching.